City. It's the Tonight Show starring...
Hello, everyone. Welcome back to the CopyCat Show, hosted by your one and only Destiny Escobedo, a.k.a. College Student. Now, today, we have a special guest who will perform the piece that he's done before. On the contrary, this guest will also be pushed out of his comfort zone to act out a scene that was featured on Kim Fallon's Tonight Show. Everyone, this is Bobby. Hello, Bobby.
Hello, Destiny. Thank you for featuring me.
How are you doing today?
I'm doing good.
Yeah.
Now, I couldn't make it today because of, you know, little issues and all, but I thought it was at least a okay or good idea for me to perform in my own house or room. Yeah.
Yeah, great. Forgot to mention that Bobby couldn't make it today, so he's virtual. Okay, now, can you introduce yourself?
I'm sorry?
Oh, can you introduce yourself to the audience?
Oh, name's Bobby. I've been performing and playing for about a year now, and I've been you know increasing a lot my playing, you know, like practicing and knowing a lot of music, and the song I'll be performing for the show is Come Together from the Beatles on their album The Abbey Road.
Great. And what made you choose that song?
I recently got myself a Douglas violin bass, which is not really a Hofner, because McCartney played an Hofner violin bass. But since it's a violin bass that McCartney played, I felt like picking a Beatles song. And one of my favorites has always been Come Together, because I really like the bass line towards it. And since I got this bass, and I thought I'd perform it on the show, you know, I think that'll be a good idea.
Great. Can't wait for us to hear the progress you've made in a year of playing.
Yes.
The bass. All right, everyone, we have Bobby.
So I perform, right?
Yeah. Hold on, Robert. Let me give you your countdown. On three, one, two, three.
Down below your feet.
Thank you, everyone, for having us. We will see you on the next episode. Welcome back to another show with your typical college student, Destiny Escapito. We have Bobby, a.k.a. Robert, his real name, performing as Mike. I'll be Josh. And Randy will be the narrator for a kid theater scene of Magic Mike the movie. But in this case, this scene has nothing to do with what actually happens in the movie. And here we are getting into it.
Josh Mike has a flat tire. He needs help.
Oh no, my bike has a flat tire. How am I gonna get to hockey practice on time? Oh, I know. I know what I'll do. I'll call Magic Mike. Magic Mike! Magic Mike!
Yes, I am Magic Mike. I'm like regular Mike, except magic.
Can you help me fix my bike tire? It's all out of air.
Yes, I can, because I'm Magic Mike. I'm like regular Mike, except magic.
You're not me.
Yeah, you said that. Just fix my bike.
Okay, fine. First, let me take out my magic bike pump. Now, where's your bike?
Right here in front of you.
Okay, now, using my magic, I'm going to pump up your bike tire, my magic bike pump. I'm using my magic.
Mike pumps up the flat tire.
My magic is working. The bike tire is pumping up.
It's almost done pumping up.
Still pumping.
Still pumping.
And now it's done. It's all done. All pumped up.
Thank you, Magic Mike. But wait a second. What's so magic about a regular bike pump?
Oh, yeah, you're right. I guess I'm just Mike.
And scene. Hello, everyone. Welcome to another episode of the Copycat Show, hosted by your typical college student, Destiny Escobedo. For today's show, we have a special guest in the studio who will perform a piece that she's done before. On the contrary, this guest will also be pushed out of her comfort zone to act out the scene that was featured on the Jimmy Fallon Tonight Show, just as in the two previous episodes. Everyone, this is Valeria.
Hello.
Hi, Valeria. How are you doing? Anything new?
I'm doing great. I've only been practicing during the summer, so my skills have only been improving.
That's great. Great to hear. Now, for those who don't know you or need a refresher, would you please introduce yourself?
Sure. My name is Valeria Larcón. I am a bandurria player, which is a Spanish instrument. And I've been doing this for around 7 years. I'm really proud of sharing the estudiantina style of music, which is what you can play on bandurria. I'm interested in sharing this style with my community.
Great. And I wasn't even aware of what a bandurria was until recently. What would you be performing today for us?
I'll be performing a traditional Mexican song, which is going to be interpreted on the bandurria. So it would be a mix of a Spanish instrument with Mexican music. It's called.
All right, everyone. Here we have it. Valeria. Can we stop?
Yeah, so we could pause it there. And then I'm rolling. I'm going to give you your countdown. 3, 2, 1. We're set.
Thank you.
Yay, everyone. So we'll put our fake audience claps and all that noise. All right, so then in this part, Destiny, do your outro.
That was amazing from an instrument that most people have never heard before. Wasn't that great, guys? Anyways, thank you guys for tuning in, and stay tuned for next time. Welcome back, guys, on Copycat. Today we'll be performing a kid theater scene based on the movie The House with a Clock in Its Walls. There's a twist to it because it's
in this case is written by a little kid named Jaden. And so I will be clock two, no, clock one, and Valeria would be clock one. And Randy will be the narrator. And here we go.
There are two clocks in the walls. The clocks are close to each other, like really close.
I'm so sick of being a clock.
Yeah, I can't even see what time it is.
You could just read my forehead.
Are you sure? That's really weird and personal.
Dude, just read it.
No.
Fine.
Clock one sticks out his tongue and waves it around.
You don't have to be so rude about it. I can't even stand you. Just shush, shush. Shush it right now.
No, I won't. Instead, let's sing a rap. Yo, it's Clock Boy. I'm here on your block trying to get out of this clock.
But can't move, stiff as a rock. You're stuck too, so don't try to mock me.
I'm gonna get out and go free. Gotta get out of this wall.
So I can hang with my friends at the mom wall. Meet some guys named Paw Paw. And that's
all. Oh, bam. And scene. Hello, everyone. Welcome to the Copycat Show, hosted by your one and only typical Destiny, the college student. Now, for today, we have a special guest who will perform a piece that she's done before. On the contrary, this guest will also be pushed out of her comfort zone to act out a scene that was featured on Jenny Fallon's Tonight. Miriam. Hey, Miriam. How's your summer? Anything excited planned?
Hang out at home, going to the beach.
Now, would you care to introduce yourself? Who are you?
My name is Miriam Lopez.
What do you like to do?
Hang out at home and going to the beach.
What would you be performing today for us?
I'm going to play I See the Lights from the movie Tangled.
Great. I really love that song. So, all right, everyone. Miriam. Yeah, I'm not that in my Welcome back to the Copycat Show. Today, we will be performing with Robert, Valeria, and myself. We will do a scene based off of Bridge of Spies. The catch is that this scene is actually written by an elementary school kid, and it has nothing to do with the actual movie. I will be the narrator. Valeria would be spy one, and Robert will be spy two. Let's do it. Two spies stand on the bridge. One of them has a pair of binoculars.
I can see the bad guys coming in the distance.
I wish I could see them too, but you're the one with the binoculars.
It's not my fault if Robert is at home.
You told me we wouldn't even need them today.
I was joking. We always need them. We're spies.
Absolutely. But we're also friends, so I trusted you.
You should never trust a spy.
But what do you? Well, what about trusting a friend spy?
Spy one and spy two look at each other. Spy one looks amazed.
Wow, I never thought about it like that before. Maybe friendship is more important than spying.
Exactly.
Here, you can have my binoculars.
Spy one hands over the binoculars to spy two.
Ha! You're such a loser. Rule number one of being a spy is never hand over your binoculars.
You tricked me. You're a good spy and I'm a bad spy.
You're right. I'm the best and you're the worst.
Oh, the bad guys are here. We have to fight them now.
We are both terrible fighters.
Quick, throw the binoculars at them.
Spy 2 throws the binoculars at the bad guy and it hits him in the face. The bad guy falls. Spy 1 puts his arm around Spy 2.
We did it. We saved the world. Let's go get lunch and talk about our friendship.
You got it.
And scene. Let me just go back into my hole.